AI videos are probably the most viral thing that's currently happening in 2025. So no wonder you're clicking on this video, trying to find out how people are doing this and what is the best generators. Well, luckily for you, I've been in this space for about 2 to 3 years now. So I've been using every single generator and have tested it from start all the way to present day to find out which one is the best, which one is the most cost effective, and what one are we going to use. So today we're going to be covering 3 main platforms. This is going to allow you to go straight in and target whatever video you want, depending on what platform you use. So firstly, we're going to be looking at Kling, Dreamina, and Runway. These are the 3 main platforms when it comes to AI video generation, and that is why we're going to be covering them today. Now, firstly, I want to point out that I've been using all 3 of these platforms for the last few months, not just for my own personal brand, but also for my AI influencers and my OF models. As you can see, I've been going viral over, over and over again with this direct method that I'm going to be teaching you today. So this isn't I've just started 1 month ago and I've just trialed out a few softwares. I've been doing this for a long time, evolving alongside with these softwares. So I know exactly how to use them, the tips and tricks to get an advantage over other users on the platforms, and also the potential future uses of these platforms to be able to improve your marketing, to be able to go viral, just like I have many times. So let's get into it. Firstly, you need to create an AI image. These generators are image to video generators. So that means that you need the initial base image, whether that's AI or yourself, it doesn't really matter. If you're going for a full AI model, I'd recommend using a platform called Kling. This can be ran locally, so on your own computer or device, or it can be ran on platforms like RunPod or Mimic PC, which allow you to host this software without having to take up loads of storage or having a high-tech computer. This is going to allow you to get the highest quality images, similar to the ones that I've been posting on my Instagram page or with my models, as you can probably see on the screen now. If you don't want to go advanced with your AI images, that's absolutely fine. You can use basic platforms, you know, fanvue.ai is a pretty good platform as well. And I've done many tutorials on how to use that basic intro level platform. For you guys that just want to kind of tinker around, you know, play with a few things, maybe just make some memes of your mates, this is a better platform to use. However, those who are more serious, I definitely recommend Kling. The quality level is going to be a lot higher and therefore your output is going to be a lot better. Because with everything with AI, the better the quality content you put in, the better quality content you get out. So that is something very, very important to keep in mind. If you are starting this business model, don't go with a low quality model. You're going to get trumped very quickly. This is the fastest advancing business model in the world currently. So that means if you come in with a low level model now, in 6 months, that is going to be an extremely, extremely low level model. So coming in with a high level model now means that in 6 months, you're going to be mid to high. So using platforms like Kling is advised. And once again, if you use it on your own computer locally, it is free to use. So it's not an expensive platform here. But this is all just to generate that basic image to start off with. Now we're going to be using the same image today, because obviously with all kind of experiments, you should have a kind of static factor. And we're going to be using this lovely model here on my left. We're going to be using her in pretty much every generator, but I'm going to show you the different capabilities of each generator so that you personally can then replicate this to grow your own business. So the first platform we're going to be using is Runway. Now the reason we would use Runway is mainly to mimic movements. Now the main reason I say this is because the image to video generators, where you're turning an image into a video, isn't actually that good. The technology is a little bit behind its times. However, they are most likely going to catch up very soon. But what they have got, which is very, very advanced, is the image video generator that mimics movement. So this is how you're going to make videos like this, which once again, I've made and I've gone viral. And you can also replicate that for your model if you want when it comes to basic marketing techniques, which once again, I've gone viral in that area as well. So listening carefully, we're going to be talking you through the basic steps. Firstly, like I mentioned, you need to get a base video because we're going to be mimicking the movements off this base video. Now this can be you, this can be someone else, whatever, it doesn't really matter. You're not going to be taking the actual video, you're just going to be mimicking the movement with your AI model, which is very good. But I always use myself personally or another influencer that I have working alongside me. So What I'm going to do is make a basic video where, let's say, I'm waving or doing like a little thumbs up just to demonstrate the technology. What I'm then going to do is take this into CapCut or some sort of video editing software, and I'm going to take the first initial frame of that and pull it out. That initial frame is how we're going to restyle this whole video into an AI model. That first initial frame, you then want to go change the face or the whole body to your AI model. So this may require some image-to-image workflows that you use in Comfy, or you can simply use InPaint on Foul.ai. Either or is absolutely fine. So what you want to do is obviously select the face, select the body that you want to change, and then click your prompt and click generate. If you have a LoRA or a pre-made model set up, you can simply attach that here, and that means you have a separate identity. However, if you just want to change it to a random person, you know, like an old man or 20-year-old blonde, which you've probably seen about 100 times, then you can do so. Pretty simple, just follow the steps that you've just seen on the screen. Click generate, you're going to get an output. That output you're then going to want to take back into CapCut and try to realign that with the initial image. This image is going to be the restyled version of this video. So that means the first initial frame needs to be in the same position as the first frame that you've put in. So what I normally like to do is just do a little adjustments, and this is why I use CapCut, because you can adjust the model's face, the person's face, and make a fairly accurate copy of the initial frame. Once that is done, great. Feel free to kind of move the base level around a little bit as well, because this is going to allow you to sync the model's face to the person's face in the original video. You're then going to go take that over to Runway. Open a new session, add the video that you've just edited, and put that in to Runway. Then you're going to take that initial frame that you've just edited with the new model, the restyled one, the one that you want to be in that video playing. You're going to put that in next to the video that you've just uploaded. Type in your prompt if you want. Most of the time I just leave that blank because I can't be asked, and then click generate. Give it a minute or two and you're going to have your output there. All nicely set up, all ready to go, waiting for you to upload to Instagram and go viral. That is number one, mimicking movements. And that's why you would use Runway, because it's a good platform to do so. And not many other platforms have this capability. So that is the first advised platform. And this will let you go viral, whether that is, means you're an AI model, OF model, normal influencer, whatever you want to do, you can go viral with this. Most of the time people use it for AI models that can't do real movements. So if you want, you know, an AI model to go like this, or, you know, wave or whatever, then you can do so quite easily without having to try prompt something for like 3 hours to try to get the perfect movement. You can just get movement to be mimicked, which is exactly what you want to do. So Runway is being that first software that we're going to use. The second one we're looking at is Dreamina. Now this platform isn't exactly a video generating software. What it is a lip sync software. However, it turns the image into a video like whilst doing so in a month, to increase that level of realism. Now this is revolutionary to this space. It means that AI models can now act as if they are real influencers online, meaning that conversions are a lot higher. You can do verbal call to actions, which is obviously amazing because it means that you can be able to get more people onto the page that you want them to get onto. So what is Dreamina? How do we use it? And what is the processes? So firstly, like I mentioned, it's a lip sync. So we need to get a new initial image of a model. Now this needs to be very high quality. So once again, it can be a real person, can be a real image, but if you want very high quality images of AI models, then we want to use comfy.ui. Funny I say, we want to use comfy.ui. Now these workflows, once again, are complicated. All our students get them for free in the mentorship and also in the course. So if you did want a high level workflow, then obviously you know where to get it. But you can find some online, so feel free to have a look or try and make one yourself. Once again, very hard to get images of this quality if you're looking at making it yourself. Probably take a few months. So for speed purposes and quality purposes, find a comfy workflow and make that image. Then you want to look at creating a voice. Now you can use the voices on Dreamina. It is free. They are there for your use. However, they do sound like robots. And do you really want just this robotic chick? Not really. You want to have ultra realism, the best voice, the best image, because that's going to get you the best conversion. People are paying for that real life experience. So, you know, real life experience or girlfriend experience or real life influencer influencing them in their life. So you don't really want that low quality robotic voice. No one really attached to that. So how are we going to get the most realistic voice we can? This is going to be on play.ht or 11 Labs. These are two softwares that are going to allow you to turn text into voice and therefore be able to create that perfect script that you want to then attach to this image and create a lovely video of the model talking. So as soon as you got on both the voice and the model, what we need to do is merge them on Dreamina. The reason we use this platform is because, one, it's really easy to use. You don't have to worry about all this hassle of editing the mouth and all of that shit that you used to do about a year or two ago. And also, it adds very good realism to the video. Now, what do I mean by that? 1 or 2 years ago, lip syncs literally used to be the mouth moving up and down. The head was like dead central, staring at the camera. And it was quite weird. However, what Dreamina does is it has the model breathing, has like the hair moving or a bit of a breeze, you know, has the model blinking, maybe looking left and right like I've just been doing there. And that's exactly what you want for realism. So it does turn this image into a video whilst adding the voice and a perfect lip sync. So this is why this is definitely within the top three platforms to use any kind of AI video generation. So all you do, add the image, add the voice, press enter, and then wait a little bit. That's literally it. There's not much more to it. Mainly because you had to do a bit of post-production, creating the voice, creating the image, so they're kind of the complicated bits. Once you merge them together within Dreamina, easy, magic's done. However, you can only do about 15 seconds worth of audio. So make sure then 15 seconds, very key and specific words, pushing the audience or telling the audience exactly what to do to get to where, or whatever you want to use this for. For example, some people use it in e-com stores. If you want, get an AR model, speak some stuff, introduce people to your little e-com store. Now look at the store, click on that, simples. Brilliant for 15 second clips. However, if you're going to be making a whole 20 minute YouTube video, that's going to be quite hard making it from each individual 15 second clip. So make sure you use this skill correctly. And with this platform, you will get very good conversions. As you've seen, I've gone viral again by using this software. So make sure you use this correctly and you will get views, you will get conversions, you will get customers, and then you'll get more money and you just start hitting them 10, 20K months on fanvue, if that's obviously what you're doing with these AR models. So coming on to the last and probably the best platform that you can use for AI videos. Now, I have no kind of affiliation for this platform. However, when I'm coaching my students to get the best results, I always advise this platform, mainly because it gets me the best results. So what platform is that? That is Kling. What can Kling do? Firstly, you can create images on this platform. Now, I would not really advise that. Kling's specialty is not images, I'm afraid, but it is in videos. So what I'll do, once again, use that comfy workflow and make the perfect realism or perfectly realistic image that you're then going to insert into this generator. Once that's in the generator, what you need to do is have specific prompts and make sure that you select the correct settings. So firstly, there's 1.6 and then there's 2. 2 is the most updated and in fact extremely impressive image to video generator. Now this is what we're going to be using today because this is going to get us the best results. However, on 1.6, you can also do a very unique feature. We have an initial and end frame. So that means through the video, the model will move and you'll be able to keep consistency of the face because you've given it two different reference images. But we'll cover that at a later state, maybe in a specialist video for Kling. What we're going to be looking at is just the basic generation of video. Now this is going to be done on 2.0. Reason for this is because it's a new update and it is going viral all over the internet because it is so good. So upload your image, simple as that. Hard part comes in where you need to get a prompt for that image to then make it do that movement. Now, a lot of people struggle with this section here. There's quite a few YouTube videos teaching you how to make a very specific prompt. There's two things that I normally do. Number one is go onto ChatGPT. Ask ChatGPT to prompt something in this way for this specific platform. Let's give you an example. Say to ChatGPT, I want a prompt for the platform Kling. I'm going to be turning an image into a video. The prompt needs to describe the model standing there, looking at the camera and dancing by moving her hips left and right emphasizing that movement. She's happy and the movement is quite calm and fluent, as if she was dancing to music. The ChatGPT thread may need a little bit of training just to get that perfect output. However, once you've got it, you can then use that to create your prompts for Kling. If you don't want to do that, you never really use ChatGPT or trained a thread correctly, or it's not really working very well, what you can do is use this basic format. Now, we would start off with the camera that you want to use. If it's like a drone camera, or if it's like a selfie or anything like that. Camera, 4K camera. So firstly, you would start off with this prompt format if you don't want to use ChatGPT. Your type of camera. Now, this could be a drone camera, this could be 8K cinematic, you know, 4K, you know, in focus or blurred background, anything like that. You want your camera settings. That is the first section. Then you want your camera movement. So if it's tracking or rotating or a fast zoom in, zoom out, all of these kind of keywords is very important to apply to that camera movement. Now, for example, 4K camera rotating around. Then normally what I put is the emphasized movement. Now, this is going to be the key part of what we're going to be looking at in the video. So our model is going to be dancing. So I'm going to be putting emphasizing hip movement, swaying left and right. Simple as that. And then we'll go into the rest of the description. So we've got 4K camera with a, let's say, static frame, because I don't really want the rotating camera. And then the model is moving her hips left and right as if she's dancing to a video. She's maintaining eye contact with the camera and isn't doing any erratic movement. Something like that could work quite well. Press enter, maybe a little bit more on a prompt at the end, just to add a bit of clarity to the generator. But you can press enter there, and that's going to go through and create your model. So that basic prompt structure of camera, camera movement, emphasized movement, and then a long description is going to be able to help you to create the perfect prompt to be able to get a good output, which is then going to go viral online. I'm not the only one going viral. I'm going to be honest. There's other people, there's other models, other creators. A lot of students of mine have hit this success with doing this AI videos. With doing AI videos on Kling. So it's extremely important that you get this prompt correctly. It's extremely important that you get the correct prompt so you get the correct output with minimum tokens. This platform isn't too expensive. It is actually quite cheap, which is good. However, if you don't prompt correctly, the output isn't going to be very good and you're going to be burning through tokens left, right, and center. So save your tokens, prompt correctly, spend less tokens, and you're going to get better outputs. If you are creating these videos, I do not recommend doing like four or five at a time. I recommend only doing one at a time and then test and adjust your prompt to get a better output. Because if you got the wrong prompt, four at a time, you've wasted a lot of tokens here. So I'd advise taking it very carefully, step by step, to get the best output as possible. But overall today, that has been everything to do with AI videos. These are the best three AI videos mentioned: Runway, Dreamina, and Kling, in that order from lowest to highest in terms of quality. I'm no way affiliated to any of these. This is just platforms that I've been using to get great success on my pages, my models, and also my students. So these are proven methods to be able to get your model from zero to 10K within a month. If you want more proof on that, we have done a video previously to get a model from zero to 5K. And also about a year ago, we've got a model from zero to 10K as well. So there's lots of information on our YouTube channel teaching you how to do this process, not just to do with these AI video softwares. So please go check them out. Feel free to learn as much as you can from us, from these free resources, and hopefully you'll have some success like myself, Kyle, and also my team and students. Thanks guys for watching. Fucking, you know, the standard outro, like, subscribe, do all of that, whatever. See you later.